Hello everyone! Today we are discussing the only vitamin which official medicine considers a medication, vitamin B3 or niacin. It is used to normalize blood cholesterol levels. First of all, we need to understand what cholesterol is. Cholesterol is a type of lipid, a material produced in the liver that our body needs to make hormones, bile acid, vitamin D, and other important substrates. Cholesterol is an essential structural component of cell membranes. It participates in the regulation of cell permeability and protects red blood cells from the action of hemolytic poisons. There are three main types of cholesterol: high-density lipoprotein, HDL or good cholesterol, low-density lipoprotein, LDL or bad cholesterol, and very low-density lipoprotein, VLDL or very bad cholesterol. The last two types of cholesterol are thought to increase chances of health problems like a heart attack or stroke. Despite this popular belief, a new review of research over the past 50 years by an international team of physicians has been published in the Expert Review of Clinical Pharmacology. This review challenges the half-century's belief that bad cholesterol causes cardiovascular diseases. Cardiologists from the United States, Sweden, Great Britain, Italy, Ireland, France, Japan, and other countries, 17 people in total, analyzed data from 1.3 million patients and found no evidence of an association between high total cholesterol levels or bad cholesterol levels and cardiovascular diseases. You can find the link below and read this comprehensive overview yourself. Let me know in the comments if you would like a detailed analysis of cholesterol and statin therapy. Very high doses of nicotinic acid, more than 100 times the recommended dietary allowance taken for months or years, are effective treatments for dyslipidemias. It means that niacin can increase good cholesterol levels and reduce bad cholesterol levels. Such doses should only be taken with medical approval and supervision. Niacin has been found to reduce the incidence of non-fatal heart attacks and prolong the life expectancy of survivors of myocardial infarction compared to other anti-cholesterol drugs. Now about niacin in more detail. Niacin, also known as vitamin B3, is one of the water-soluble B vitamins. Niacin is the generic name for nicotinic acid, nicotinamide, and related derivatives such as nicotinamide riboside. Nicotinic acid is not accidentally consonant with nicotine. It was first obtained by a German chemist Huber by oxidizing nicotine extracted from tobacco. But no one knew about its vitamin properties. In 1937, Evelheim discovered that nicotinic acid can treat pellagra in patients. Pellagra is a disease caused by low levels of niacin. It's marked by dementia, diarrhea, and dermatitis, also known as the 3 Ds. If left untreated, pellagra can be fatal. Niacin is part of the enzymes involved in cellular respiration and protein metabolism. It is required for the synthesis of many hormones such as sex hormones, estrogen, progesterone, testosterone, thyroid hormone, thyroxine, pancreatic hormone, insulin, and adrenal hormone, cortisone. Niacin is recommended for patients with type 1 diabetes. With regular use, it can reduce the number of insulin injections. Although some studies have found that nicotinic acid doses of 1.5 grams per day or more are most likely to increase blood glucose levels in individuals with or without diabetes, this issue is worth exploring further. In osteoarthritis, nicotinamide is recommended to relieve pain and improve joint health. Nicotinamide has a mild sedative effect for emotional and neuropsychiatric disorders, including anxiety, depression, and decreased attention. It is also used in complex therapy in the treatment of alcoholism. Vitamin B3 is present in a wide variety of foods. Plant-based foods include broccoli, carrots, dates, peanuts, tomatoes, potatoes, and spinach. Animal products include beef liver, eggs, milk, and cheese. Rich in this vitamin are bread products made from wholemeal flour, buckwheat, legumes, some mushrooms, and many herbs. By using the amino acid tryptophan, the body can make its own niacin. Do you remember what vitamin can also be synthesized in the body? Of course, vitamin D. And I have two detailed videos about this vitamin, links in the description box. So, tryptophan is another food source of niacin because this amino acid can be converted to niacin. Turkey is an example of a food high in tryptophan. 60 mg tryptophan can be converted to 1 mg niacin. However, the efficiency of this conversion varies considerably in different people. The daily requirement of the body for niacin in adults is 14-16 mg of niacin equivalent NE. In pregnant and lactating women, 18-17 mg NE respectively. In infants from birth to 6 months is 2 mg niacin. For children and adolescents, niacin RDAs are extrapolated from adult values on the basis of body weight. If the body does not get enough niacin, a deficiency may develop. Signs of niacin deficiency are depression, dizziness, fatigue, insomnia, cracks, and inflammation of the skin. Severe niacin deficiency leads to pellagra, a disease characterized, as I said before, by the three Ds – dementia, diarrhea, and dermatitis. The World Health Organization recommends treating pellagra with 300 mg per day nicotinamide in divided doses for 3-4 weeks along with a B-complex or yeast product to treat likely deficiencies in other B vitamins. Nicotinic acid and nicotinamide are the two most common forms of niacin in supplements. The only difference is that niacin, nicotinic acid, can cause redness of the skin as it has a more pronounced vasodilating effect. Nicotinamide does not reduce skin flushing because of its slightly different chemical structure. If you prefer to take niacin, you can reduce the redness by taking it on a full stomach or with an equal amount of inositol. It is usually available in doses ranging from 50 to 1000 mg in tablets and powders. Niacin is a wonderful vitamin that can lower blood cholesterol levels, increase circulation, lower blood pressure, and is essential for a healthy nervous system, prevents and relieves migraines, reduces dizziness in Meniere's syndrome, a condition of the inner ear, and prevents depression and dementia as well. That's it! Subscribe to my channel in order not to miss my next video. Take care of your body, mind, and cholesterol level. Bye!